name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
As we gather tonight to celebrate the Feast of All Souls Day, let us lift up to the Lord in a very special way our departed loved ones, from our family, from our parish, from our circle of friends. To prepare ourselves for this Mass, we call to mind our weaknesses. Lord Jesus, you came to heal us of our sins. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your mercy and love are without end. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we come before you, pleading your healing and forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, and as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened, so may our hope of resurrection for your departed servants also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if in the sight of others indeed they be punished, yet is their hope of full immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation they shall shine, and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love. Because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
I shall.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us, in that while we were sinners, still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if, while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Was up in Calvary Cemetery today for the burial of Margaret, but also to make a little visit and say a prayer for all the faithful departed. It was a perfect day to go to the cemetery, cold, damp, and chilly. But when we go to the cemetery, it is an opportunity for us to always think about our relatives, our friends, and pray for them. On this All Souls Day, we remember all those who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, and ask the Lord to be merciful to them and to reward them for all the good they have done. Here in our church, we have two ways of remembering the dead. Here, right by the Blessed Mother statue, is a list of all those who have died since last year at this time. As you look over those, I'm sure you recognize many of the names. We hope, we pray, that they will enjoy the rewards of eternal life someday in heaven. We really don't know what happens after death, but our faith tells us God is good God is just, God is merciful. And so as we go before the Lord, it is our hope that the just and merciful God will be a good shepherd to us. Another way of remembering our faithful departed is the book of the names of the dead. At any time before Mass or after Mass, feel free to come up to write the name of a loved one who recently died, especially if they died a long distance away. This is a way to remember them here close at home. Tonight we have the reading of the Beatitudes, which is usually read on All Souls Day. It reminds us that God is telling us another word for blessed is happy or fortunate. But then it seems odd. Fortunate are the poor in spirit, fortunate are those who mourn. We have to watch the tense in which it's read. For those that mourn, it will be fortunate later. For those who are poor in spirit, their fortune will be in heaven. And so as we read the Beatitudes, we see they really are blessings about our future life with God, eternity in the Lord. As God is merciful and ready to reward us, so we should be fortunate to those who are in need among us. As we celebrate All Souls Day then today, we pray for each other that we will be instruments of God's peace in our world, and that we will honor and pray for all our faithful departed. Place our prayers before the Lord, our Shepherd, who provides for all our needs.
That the Church may continue to grow in holiness as she spreads her message of salvation to the world, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
That elected officials may be blessed with courage and compassion in their work to uphold the dignity and sanctity of life from conception through natural death, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
That those who cannot practice their faith openly may be upheld and strengthened through the outpouring of the Holy Spirit, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
That the love of God may be poured into the hearts of those among us who are grieving the loss of a loved one in this past year, we pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be shepherded by Christ to heaven and to dwell in the house of the Lord forever, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all souls for whom this Mass is being offered and who we remember in this month of November, we pray to the Lord.
Heavenly Father, we ask that you hear and answer our prayers in accordance with your will. We ask these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Standing all things sad.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Look favorably upon our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servants may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the salvation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exalted praise as we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are redeemed, O Lord, the fount of all happiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dew. They may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Alfred, our Bishop, and all the clergy, the men and women in consecrated life, and all the people of God. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, or by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us extend the sign of that peace to those around us. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
have Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your departed servants, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is ended. Let us go in God's name.